Welcome to today's edition of Crypto Corner at InvestorIdeas.com. News on what's driving the cryptocurrency market. Hey everyone, this is Sam Mowers here and welcome to episode 598 of the Crypto Corner podcast. For news today, Bitcoin briefly broke $40,000, Banksa has reported its financial results, Neptune Digital has entered into an agreement with Luxor Technology, and Blue Sky Digital has received approval for a mining power increase. Just before we get into the show, though, a quick reminder that if you enjoy this podcast, please feel free to share it or even leave us a review. And as always, I recommend checking out some of the other podcasts on InvestorIdeas.com. This includes the Clean Tech and Climate Change podcast, the Cannabis podcast, and many others, all of which will bring you up to speed on the latest stock news and trends in their respective spaces. So Bitcoin is in the green again this morning, having risen to $40,782 USD earlier this morning. This is according to data from CoinMarketCap. This is the highest it has traded since last Friday, which was May 21st. It has since pulled back a bit and is trading for around $39,150 at the time of recording, still up from yesterday. Ether has also seen some growth, having peaked at $2,911 this morning and trading for about $2,730 at the time of recording. Banksa Holdings, Inc., which trades on the TSXV under the ticker symbol BNXA, has reported its financial results for the quarter ended March 31, 2021. In that period, the company saw revenue of 21 million AUD, that's Australian dollars, an increase over the 1.3 million recorded in the same period of 2020. Banksa's CEO Holger Arians commented, quote, "We are very happy to announce these results. Over the previous 3 months, we have been focused on improving the service and experience for our customers and expanding our capacity to service the rapidly growing demand. The industry is maturing with greater infrastructure and interest. Our aim is to be at the forefront of this new stage of development." End quote. Neptune Digital Assets Corp., which trades on the TSXV under the ticker symbol NDA, has entered into a hash rate management agreement with Luxor Technology Corporation to jointly work on hardware sourcing, mining machine hosting, and physical and virtual management of rigs while utilizing Luxor's proprietary mining pool technologies. Neptune CEO Cale Moody said, quote, "We are pleased to launch our initiative with Luxor in the United States and look to grow that relationship and our associated mining operations in the coming weeks and months. We are excited to leverage Luxor's deep expertise in Bitcoin mining, ASIC markets, hash rate management, and pool services to build a highly profitable mining program. Neptune is positioned extremely well given $40 million in capital was raised towards the near-term market top, and now we can secure assets at much lower prices. The market timing has worked in our favor, and we iterate to our shareholders that in this sector, patience pays off." End quote. Blue Sky Digital Assets Corp., which trades on the CSE under the ticker symbol BTC, has been approved for an increase of power to its primary Canadian mining facility, which is expected to enable support between an approximate 1,500 to 2,000 additional mining assets. The company's COO, Anthony R. Perlman, explained, quote, "From a business perspective, we smartly planned well in advance for controlled and staged growth for our active mining presence and associated assets, and this increase in capacity allows us to execute on our scale plans and realize continuing growth in our overall mining operations." End quote. That does it for today's Crypto Corner. If you would like to be a guest or sponsor for this podcast, contact InvestorIdeas.com. Investor Ideas reminds all listeners to read our disclaimers and disclosures on the InvestorIdeas.com website. And this podcast is not an endorsement to buy products, services, or securities. Investors are reminded all investment involves risk and possible loss of investment. To hear more InvestorIdeas.com podcasts, please visit InvestorIdeas.com/audio. And a reminder, you can also hear our podcasts on Apple Podcasts, Audible, Spotify, TuneIn, Stitcher, Spreaker.com, iHeartRadio, Google Play Music, and most audio platforms available.